And there's been an outbreak of food poisoning at Kofi's kennels. So that's me wading through duck sick all morning. Then I am carnally invited.
Cordially.
Or whatever, it's Sophie Blake's princess party. I swear everyone wants a piece of me today. I am not an octopus. Who's texting me now? Oh, yeah, it's yours. Hey, by the way, the police have let our pest go. I don't know how, but that's some good news, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right. Don't work too hard.
All right. Love you.
Love you.
Yeah, I'm sure an education is wasted on you at this point, but hadn't you better toddle off? I've got work to do.
Nuef de papi pu ili fu fumi.
What are you doing?
Getting an education. French, right?
Put them back.
When I was younger, I loved the circus. Taught myself how to juggle and everything.
Don't you dare.
How much does it cost anyway?
Twice the amount you and Leah are bleeding me for. Put them down.
I think it's a bit selfish having all this booze in the house when my dad don't even drink.
What I said, Lucas. Put them down! Now! What you did, you vile little brat!
James! What the hell do you think you're playing at?
I had to smuggle that through customs.
I don't care if you want to ride a donkey bareback from Honolulu to Hollyoaks. It doesn't give you the right to go ballistic at me, son. It's clearly an accident.
You know what? I've had enough of this charade.
What are you doing?
It's time you knew what's really been going on in this house. Truth is...
I took the wine.
Are you just a teenage alky now?
No. I just... It was just a...
Prank. Lucas has been stealing my wine and hiding it in inappropriate places. It's something he does now for a laugh.
Is it? Since when?
Caught me this time, didn't you, Jimbo? I went to put it back, and then...
It, slipped from his hands, because of all the moisturiser he's been stealing from me.
You sat to moisturise it?
Oh, really, there. Look, anyway, no harm done. Hadn't you be getting to school?
Yeah, French.
I can't believe he started moisturising.
Yeah, well, come on your way. Those doggos won't look after themselves. That's it. Yeah, now, bye.
See you later.
All right, sorry about that. How can I help? Look, Dad.
Peri and Leela are on their way over.
Why?
There's something we need to tell you. So, pointing the finger at us for Rayne's murder.
We had to tell the police what happened that night. We had no choice. Whew, right, well, I'm not gonna lie. This was, you two together, that's, well, it's a lot to take in.
A lot to take in?
Dad.
It's an abomination, is what it is.
James, calm down.
Juliet's only been gone a few months. You couldn't keep your grubby little hands off each other.
No, I wasn't like that.
Sorry, have I got my dates wrong? Or were you sleeping together while she was dying of cancer?
Right, listen, James, I know this is a bit of a shock, yeah? But, I mean, at least Pez and Romeo had the guts to tell us.
Guts? They said it themselves. They were just saving their snivelling little backsides.
Oh, I think they're both grieving. Neither of us were thinking straight. It just happened. Simple as that.
Oh, I'm sorry, I can't listen to any more of this.
Oh, come on, Dad. I'm sure Dad'll come around.
It's not just James. What happens when Steve finds out or the village gossips?
I don't care what Pearl at Price Slice has to say or Nana McQueen with a little bingo makes. They've not been through the year that we have. We might not have been thinking about Jules in the moment, but we were there for the whole thing. We held her hand. She was so young. So beautiful.
So gobby.
I'm so glad that I've had you to lean on since she's been gone.
I loved her so much.
So did I. Which is why we can't let anyone tell us how we should feel or how we should act.
Even if the way we acted was reckless.
Like, none of us meant for that to happen.
But it did. I've already embarrassed myself enough.
No, you haven't. I can't do that again. We should have never gone there in the first place.
And just when I thought I'd heard everything, them two copping off with each other. What?
You just wind your neck in. Taking you've heard the news. Look, guys, I'm sorry, all right?
Yeah, well, we might not understand it. But at the end of the day, who are we to judge, Hasty?
Now, you know what everyone's like around here? They all like to stick the beak, and this is going to be the talk of the village now.
Right, and what's new? Our family always gives people something to gossip about.
And I hope you understand how your dad must feel. He has lost so much, and I'm not having him go back to that place he was when your gran died.
No. Mum knows, won't it?
Good. Give it a bit of time, and I'm sure he'll come round.
Yeah, won't you?
Well, the amount of crap I've put you and your mum through over the years, what kind of uncle would I be if I turned me back on you now? Come here.
Thank you.
Right, I better get off. I forgot my magic wand. Don't ask.
It stays right, you know. Your dad will come round. Not like you two are gonna have another roll around, is it?
Steve! Where's your dad?
Oh, at some kids' party or something. Now, what do you think of my new dress?
Looks cheap.
Well, I can assure you it wasn't cheap. No, thanks to your very generous allowance.
Now, Jimbo.
Keep that up, and the deal's off.
Would you stop goading him? I want to do a good thing here.
Where the suck up?
James, you're here.
I am so sorry. Heard about Peri and
Romeo. We've had the worst day.
Yeah, it's been horrific. But you're here now, so that makes things better. And I have a little surprise for you.
No, come on. I don't deserve one. Mm-hmm. All right, you're a dick. Show me. No way. An invite to the Earl's big ball?
Yeah, you'd love it. VIP all the way, baby.
Tony's gonna be livid, come here.
Oh, this is why I love you.
I'm really late for Sophie and Sienna.
Where's me one? Well, someone's gonna get a VIP scene too when I get back later. Ooh. All right, in a bit. He'll still flip out when I tell him what you've been doing.
Well, after the day I've had, my insolent little friend, you're the least of my worries. Now, I'm off to have a nice bubble bath while I wait for my man to return. So do what you like, micro hay. Do your worst.